You need a win, who need a win? That's all we do. I've been a king and I've been about mine. Never could doubt mine. They running the route, I leave an outline when I hit.
There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Green Bay Packers and the Detroit Lions. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, we look at this Lions team entering play. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row. Across the 10, but try to escape the shadow of their goalpost. That helped. 10 yards, first down.
It's a gain of
10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On 2nd down now, Gilmore. And just not a ton of room to work with. He'll get it to the 15 for a gain of 2. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. Now this is a big 3rd down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. They'll keep it on the ground. Gilmore. And he is going to have the 1st down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. On 1st down, Gilmore, and he's got it past. past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Now a timeout called for by the defense as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
They'll run on first down. Gilmore. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A big pickup there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Now a give right side. Gilmore. And he's taken down inside the 30. 10 more there and another first down.
The tackle by Jeff Okuda.
On first down, Gilmore. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So it's all over. A Green Bay victory. And, you know, it wasn't a shutout. They did give up the points in the first quarter. But second, third, and fourth quarter, they held them scoreless.
Brandon, if you throw a shutout for quarters 2, 3, and 4, you win a lot of games in this league. And this felt a lot like, almost like if you say baseball, and the pitcher goes through the lineup the first time, and the hitters get to see him. And then they come out after that, and the bats start blazing, right? I think they saw their best stuff in the first quarter and just shut everything down from that point on. What a great, convincing performance.
So for the Packers, the win means they'll finish the first half at a respectable 5-3 record. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Atlanta to take on the Falcons. Meanwhile, for the Lions, they fall 2 games under 500 now at 3-5. And they'll try and turn things around next week as they have a date at Soldier Field with the Chicago Bears. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Ford Field.